beautiful, still lake. A relaxing place for most, but for me, an anxiety-provoking web of what-ifs. What if I jump in and something bites me and I get sick? What if I freak out and I can't go in and then everyone sees me upset? What if there's a rock below the surface and as I'm swimming, I swim into it and I get hurt? What if the water's dirty? What if? I don't know, what if? These are the first things that come to my mind when I think of going to the lake with my friends. They're all what ifs, all driven by fear and anxiety, all telling me that going to the lake is just too risky. My heart starts beating and my palms get sweaty and all my thoughts get stuck in a loop of all the unknowns. Should I go? Should I stay? I want to go, but I also want to stay. I begin to picture graphic images of all the things that could go wrong. And to make them stop, I ask for reassurance. I start tapping my foot in patterns of three and snapping my fingers. There seems to be no right answer. No way out, no winning. I feel trapped, I melt down into tears, and I get even more frustrated. I have an anxiety attack, driven by this fear and frustration. I experience this cycle a lot in my life. I have anxiety, I have OCD. OCD is more than just having your stationery lined up just so. OCD is a crippling anxiety disorder that looks different for everyone, but truly affects a person's quality of life. It reportedly affects up to 3% of the population. It can affect all genders, ages, and ethnic backgrounds. OCD manifests itself in the form of obsessions and compulsions. An obsession is a worry that a person experiences, and this causes them anxiety. It's usually a thought or an image. Then to relieve that anxiety, a person will perform compulsions. It can be anything from seeking reassurance, to tapping, to counting, to saying sorry excessively or washing your hands. I had an onset of OCD when I was 12. Before my OCD appeared, I used to be a kid that loved going outside. I loved bugs, I loved hikes, I loved being with my friends, I loved being dirty. I'd embrace the dirt, being outside, I enjoyed it. My OCD began to worsen as I got older, and I started having anxiety around getting hurt and being dirty and getting sick. And these anxieties made traveling and doing outdoor activities a lot more difficult. I wanted to be adventurous. I wanted to do the same things that my friends were doing, but I felt stuck. They were too hard. I felt like I had lost a piece of my identity. I wasn't adventurous anymore. The media often portrays adventure as belonging to those who are strong and active. People who are fit and take risks and do crazy things in crazy places. Adventure is even defined as an unusual and exciting activity, typically hazardous experience. As someone with OCD, that definition didn't fit me, so I made my own. I started to question what adventure really meant. And to me, adventure is an activity you choose to do, even though it may be hard and sometimes uncomfortable. Adventure is about pushing your own limits. At the beginning of my treatment process, my adventures probably didn't seem like adventures to most. They didn't seem like adventures to me. They included sitting on the grass, not climbing mountains. They included using porta potties and getting dirty and picnicking. But they were adventures because they were challenging for me, and I chose to do them because I wanted to grow. There were many ups and downs and a lot of major setbacks, but also a lot of major accomplishments. They included swimming in the lake, going traveling with my family, and this past fall going on a 3-day camping trip with my friends. It was pretty crazy, I must admit. Quite an adventure. I learned a lot over my years of going through treatment and dealing with my mental health, and I'd like to share those. And so the first thing I learned is that hard things are hard. And it sounds simple, but it's true, and they don't get easier until you do them. I often feel really frustrated when my limits aren't the same as other people's. But just because it's easy for them doesn't make it easy for me. And doing hard things isn't always fun. It can be uncomfortable, but that uncomfortable feeling usually means you're pushing your limits and learning something new. That's a good thing. But also remember that you know you best, and sometimes it's okay to choose to be comfortable. We are not always able to take the risks. When pushing yourself, remember to have people around you to support you. A bunch of small challenges plus a lot of time equals achieving big goals. and things do get easier. With those things in mind, try not to pass up any opportunity to try something new or have a new experience. I know what it's like to fear the unknown, but try to limit the what-ifs, because possible doesn't always mean probable. I have not been able to accept every opportunity offered to me right away. Sometimes the anxiety is too overwhelming, but whenever possible, I try to not let anything pass me by. It helps me to view every opportunity as a learning experience. Either it goes horribly wrong and I become more resilient, or it goes really right and I have a lot of fun. I used to hate walking in the forest, for example. It was uncomfortable and very anxiety-provoking, but after doing it a ton of times, I've actually come to really enjoy it. And with that being said, I can say that there is hope, so much hope. No matter the barriers or struggles, with determination, you can overcome them. After all, everyone has a story. Everyone struggles with their own mental and physical barriers. Some days are hard, and sometimes you may feel very defeated. It took a couple of years for me to finally go camping. And even then, the camping trip was not easy, but I still considered it a success. It took me going to the lake and watching my friends swim many times before I could finally jump in. But I got there. The first time was hard, the second time was hard, the third time was only a little bit easier, and by the sixth, you might say I was having fun. Adventure truly belongs to everyone. There's a place for everyone to be adventurous. It belongs to all the people who push their own limits. It belongs to those who face challenges, the big and the small. It belongs to those who choose to never stop learning and to never stop growing. Your adventure may not look like the Google image search of adventure, but that's okay, because adventure belongs to you. Thank you.